is this not safe?
They have non-threatening names like spice or bath salts, but they are dangerous and they have been deadly. In fact, these synthetic drugs are blamed for sending 11,000 people to U.S. emergency rooms in 2010. There are laws banning the chemical compounds they contain, but makers are finding loopholes, creating newer versions faster than states can expand their bans. Naomi Pescovitz is here now to explain how Minnesota lawmakers are hoping they can stop this problem. Naomi?
Leah, law enforcement is trying to beat these drug makers at a game they know well. Here's what we're talking about. This is the chemical makeup of what we know as bath salts. One small change and it becomes something else, something that could be legal but just as dangerous.
Synthetic drugs could have ruined the lives of 21-year-old Kat Ryan and 22-year-old Nate Wilson.
I didn't know if I was having a heart attack or what was going on.
I have friends that are in prison now because of selling it. I have another kid's heart exploded because of it. Like, they're not safe.
Starting in his teens, Nate wasn't only experimenting.
That was my label. I was known as the person that could get the people these crazy drugs.
Now he's getting back on the right path at Minnesota Teen Challenge and knows the challenge law enforcement faces fighting the ever-changing world of synthetic drugs.
Ooh, they used to always come out with new different kinds of K2 that just with a different ingredient in it.
Representative Eric Simonson is now proposing a bill that would make it a crime to sell or possess synthetic drug lookalikes.
And it still looks like the same product, and clearly the intent is there that they want to sell this stuff so that people can get high with it.
Last year, Governor Dayton signed a bill expanding the list of synthetic drugs. It also gives the Board of Pharmacy more authority to define other substances, and selling some of them is now a felony. But the drug makers are crafty. But
the problem is, as soon as you put something into statute that includes a list of ingredients, all they have to do is change one ingredient, and then they're back to selling quote-unquote legal products again.
A simple tweak to a molecule and lives drastically changed.
You're walking on thin ice. You really have no idea what you're getting yourself into.
And the lookalikes bill is one way of fighting this problem. The Minnesota Board of Pharmacy is also working with legislators to get new drugs on the list of banned substances as they come out. Reporting live, Naomi Pescovitz, 5 Eyewitness News.
Let's take a look now at the 38 states that ban both synthetic marijuana and so-called bath salts. Most others outlaw one or the other, and many ban a certain list of compounds, while others ban entire classes of the drug. Lawmakers in Indiana and Rhode Island are currently working on legislation to broaden their bans, similar to what's being proposed here in Minnesota. We wanted to know if the current bans are really having an impact, and we found numbers of synthetic drug calls to poison control centers did fall after a federal ban took effect in July, but the numbers still remain high. Take a look at the numbers in the past 3 years. So far this year, there have been nearly 600 calls.
There's new fallout tonight over the Harlem Shake. The Mound Westonka School Board has approved the resignation of its activities director. The move comes after students were punished recently after their lunchroom version of the internet dance craze, the Harlem Shake. Dion Colts was placed on administrative leave following the suspension of 7 students after they performed the dance. Parents demanded an apology. The district agreed the initial punishment wasn't warranted. The school board approved the decision last night in hopes that everyone involved can move forward. People shared emotional stories as part of a push.